Hello everyone, my name is Bharat. I work as a product manager at Nextmapping. I have 5+ years experience in solar tracker design and product management tool. So today I will be presenting on tracker technology trends, that is the product features which you can see more common in the future in tracker industry. First of all, I would like to thank Solar Energy International for giving me an opportunity to present on trackers here in this forum. I will begin with a brief on Nextracker, which has become a tracker technology leader due to its innovative technology and itself has become a trendsetter for the tracker industry as such. So rapid growth since inception, 7 gigawatts delivered to date, number one tracker company worldwide as per GKM research report, and we have manufacturing capacity of 150 megawatts per week. Flex acquired Nextracker more than 1.5 years back, and we have been scaling together in the solar industry since then. So Flextronics has a huge financial backing. It is $26 billion. It has $26 billion annual revenue, 100+ manufacturing sites with 30 global offices, and it has PV module capacity of 1.7 gigawatts, largest outside of China. This is our executive team. Our CEO is Dan Sugar. They have collectively more than 7 gigawatts of experience in PV system design, installation, and project management. This is our global customers footprint. We can see our presence in almost every continent. This is our unmatched tracker legacy. Our executive team, our founders have started the tracker, working on trackers from 1993 and slowly scaled it up, and now we can see almost every project in US has trackers, and we are seeing the same throughout the world. You can see in 2017 we have 100 megawatts of Punjab. Nextracker has been extensively evaluated by third party organizations such as DNVGL, who has given a favorable bankability report for us. We have a comprehensive wind tunnel test done from CPP. Our tracker design gets evaluated through external structural consultants such as Structurology, and we have a corrosion consultant, JDH. So all these guys have extensively validated our tracker, and that's been the reason for growth. This is a classic slide on trackers versus fixed, why you want to use a tracker compared to a fixed. This is a generation from a fixed tilt. You get a very smooth generation and hits the peak during afternoon hours. And this is a generation from a tracker. You get the peak for much longer duration. And you can see the boost as high as like 15 to 30% based on the location. So this makes a classic sense, like why you want to use a tracker over a fixed tilt. It kind of it reduces your LCOE, which is in turn your tariff. In last 20 years, the tracker prices have come down significantly, by almost 75%, matching with the module prices. Coming to tracker technology trends, like I said, my presentation will be focused primarily on this. So, which features we will be seeing more common in the future, and in the tracker industry. Nextracker itself has been, being a technology leader, was the industry first to introduce 93 module row, self-grounded tracker, self-powered tracker, and predictive analytics, introduced the predictive analytics through digital version. These have become a trend itself in the tracker industry. Traditionally, many of you might be knowing the tracker row as typical tracker row length was 40 module. Now, Nextracker was the first to introduce 80 module row, now expandable up to 93 module. And now more and more tracker suppliers are having this feature, and they're now, if not there, are trying to achieve it. Self-grounded tracker, primarily you don't require any grounding cable, any additional labor for doing grounding. This is a big savings, especially in US, where you need a separate certified consultant, certified engineer who has to do this grounding, and our tracker is listed to UL2703 as well. Self-power tracker, Nextracker was the first to introduce self-power tracker. Every row has an integrated UPS, this is a feature which we have seen many of the tracker suppliers are coming up with, and it will become more of a norm in the future. And of course, the wireless communication through ZigBee protocol, so every row will communicate to the master controller. And through digital O&M, it was unheard of like 5 to 6 years back on trackers, like how do you track or monitor through remote monitoring, for especially on trackers. Sorry for that. So now you can track your motor performance, looper performance.
Thank you.
apologize for the trouble we have in the trouble. So the same things will be repeating in my slides further because these have been the industry first. I mean, Nextracker became introduced these to the tracker industry, and this kind of became a norm and something to be achieved in the tracker industry. So individual road tracker, you might have observed like in last 5 to 6 years, you have more number of single road tracker suppliers, individual road tracker suppliers, than compared to a linked row. The benefits speak to itself, which I'll be showing here. So first of all, you would be getting a much higher PV capacity in the same layout compared to a linked row tracker. You can, as an example, you can achieve almost like 2.8 megawatt more PV compared to a linked row tracker. That itself is a big boost given the land acquisition challenges in India. So another benefit with individual row tracker is you can do a faster cleaning. You can go from one end of the row, one end of the plant actually, to the other end of the plant at a single go, compared to a linked row where you will have to stop at the middle due to linkage and come back, take a U-turn, and do the same process to the rest of the other half of the tracker block. And if you have an auto clean mode like Nextracker has, you can rotate, I mean, you can have the tracker rows facing each other, and you can do much even faster cleaning. So these are the key advantages of a single row tracker. You can do an easier row in them. You can do a self-power tracking, as to drive a single row is much lesser than compared to a linked row. You can achieve 10 to 20% or even more PV per site. You can do 5x faster cleaning, as I shown in the example. So this is another benefit of an individual row tracker compared to linked row. Let's say a drive system fails in a linked row tracker, then the whole tracker block kind of stops and you lose much higher generation compared to individual row tracker, where a drive failure would only stop that particular row. And you can observe here the energy loss is almost like 5,000% less. So Nextracker was the industry first to introduce self-power tracker with wireless communication. We are already seeing few tracker suppliers having this feature in their offerings. This will become more of a norm in the future because nobody likes power cables, nobody likes communication cables, especially creating trenches. Already we struggle with creating trenches, and now we don't want to create trenches for trackers. So with plug and play commissioning, this is much smoother and faster to execute and install. Digital O&M, the slide speaks to itself. So through digital O&M, you can remotely monitor performance of almost every component, mechanical or electrical. You can you can find what is the tracker angle, what is the actual sun position should be, then you can do a predictive analytics based on that. You can check battery health, battery performance, health of your controller. You can do motor performance, sugar performance, and using all this data, you can do a predictive analytics, which is what almost every tracker company is aspiring to. A lot of IoT platform is being brought into this. Row-to-row tracking is another hot topic which is happening in tracker industry. This is another advantage of an individual row tracker, wherein especially in undulating lands, the linked row tracker cannot have row-to-row tracking being linked itself. This is especially beneficial in undulating lands. As you can observe, in undulating lands, you can see a shadow from one row to the next row. And through row-to-row tracking, you can avoid all the shading. Of course, it requires a little bit robust algorithm. You can gain almost like up to 4% depending on how much the land is undulated. So this is something little bit new to the tracker industry. A lot of validation is happening, but this is something which we will be seeing more often in the future. Next is your tracker design or compatibility for 1500 volt systems. As we already have modules compatible for 1500 volt and inverter scaling up, 1500 volt inverter scaling up rapidly, it makes perfect sense to have trackers compatible for 1500 volt system configuration. These are the benefits of a 1500 volt system. Significant savings, especially on the DC side. Your combiner boxes would come down, your cabling would come down, your labor cost would come down. And the good part is with NX Horizon, which is perfectly suited for a 1500 volt system, the tracker quantity would also be coming down by 11%, with cost per unit remaining almost the same or slight increase. You can observe almost 2.5 cents per watt DC savings with transitioning to a 1500 volt. And the trackers are suited for 1500 volt. And this will become more of a, again, there's still some tracker companies which are offering 40 module rows, which are not ideally suited for, because you require 30 module string configuration. So you'll be seeing more like multiples of 30, like 60 or 90. This is a comparison with the 1500 volt systems. The typical block size which is targeted is 3 megawatt AC. You can see the same number of combiner boxes was used for 3 megawatt as used in 2 megawatt. That shows the significant savings in a 1500 volt system. And your DC losses would be coming down. So this is a project reference which was done by NextTracker. You can see the quantity of trackers coming down by 11%, which was shown in my earlier slide. And the other benefits which was observed in the DC side. NextTracker product NX Horizon has been deployed over gigawatt at 1500 volt system at 1500 volt DC, and we have certifications UL2703 and UL3703 for 1500 volt DC systems. So these are the standard configurations, more or less designed around 30 modules per string. Depending on the weather, cold climates, you cannot go beyond 30 or maybe even 87. So you can do only probably like 29 modules per string in colder regions. And you can probably in India, we can extend it up to 93 modules per row. Land acquisition itself is a challenge, and getting a flat land is even further challenge. So tracker industry has geared up to take up the challenge. This is an example, like NX Horizon has a 15% not so great tolerance, very high, even fixed tilt can't match this tolerance. We expect a savings of up to like 1 million in grading costs. As you can observe, a simple fix in the brackets would result in achieving this 15% slope. So this feature is becoming more and more common. Actually, from my experience, almost every tracker company is, especially in US and Europe, we can see this as very standard feature now. Of course, in India, it's still not at there, but I think it will. We can observe this more than common. Another point which I would like to emphasize is on the controls part. We do not have, actually, the link rows do not have much clearance from the ground. As you can see here on the right side, it's very close to the ground, and we have practical experience in solar park during heavy rains. The solar park gets flooded, and this can cause damage to your drive systems, and this can result in further breakdowns, and this could be even unpredictable. So NX Horizon has a control system installed at like 1 meter height or above. This will become more of a common feature in the, you can observe this becoming more of a common norm in the tracker industry to have controls and drive systems at a higher level. So moving to a single row would help enable to achieve this much more efficiently. With that, I would like to conclude my presentation and take up any question.
What's the percentage of projects in India that
I've not looked at the GTM report, but we ourselves are executing more than 400-500 megawatts of tracker systems. And our positioning is around 50 to 60% of the trackers installed in this region, in India.
So we don't have a ballpark?
It would be about a gigawatt, I would say. I mean, if you take, so the growth in trackers, especially in India, has been very slow. Predominantly it has been fixed in. But since across the world, across the globe, like everybody is moving to trackers, like you take South America, US, so that has gave a big push, and with falling tariffs, it made a perfect sense to move towards trackers. So we'll be slowly seeing the growth, and GTM has pointed out that India would be the primary hub for trackers in the future.
So thanks.
So I believe you started your manufacturing in Chennai, is that right?
So there is a recent announcement that we would be tying up with a local manufacturer for making a few components here. That's true.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that would be like
Yeah, sure. I mean, that's the whole intention. Unless you make a commercial sense, we do not invest. So definitely you can expect.
Okay. And also you mentioned about the automatic cleaning. What was that?
It's not automatic cleaning, it's auto cleaning mode.
Oh.
So NexTracker has this auto switch. You can do it remotely also. So when you do that, the tracker rows will face each other.
Oh, I see. So they're just...
Yeah.
Okay.
So they'll face each other and you can clean the tracker, the PV panels at one go. You can go from one end of the plant to the other end without even stopping anywhere.
One question about motorized self-powered trackers.
Yeah.
What kind of maintenance problems you see after a couple of years, and what's the percentage of you lose on those? I mean, net profit or gross profit, whatever it is.
Yeah.
One is power loss due to the self-powered. Number two, again maintenance and again replacement at end of life, whatever it is, on moving parts plus. Yeah.
Yeah. So I can't speak of in general for trackers, other trackers, but for NexTracker, I could say like our most reliable component is the slew gear, which actually rotates the top tubes through a motor. I mean, of course, the motor drives it, and it is the most reliable part in our system. So it's actually even like hub fasteners we use. So it's like kind of even removing it is little, it has its own procedure. And we went to that stage because it's our most reliable component in that tracker. Coming to motor, it's an easy fix, but our failures were actually, till now, I think we have observed only 5,000 units installed for, like as shown, we have installed about 4 gigawatts and we saw around 5,000 units which have failed. And it's an easy fix, you can just remove and put it. And whenever such failure happens, this is a good part of a linked row, right? I mean, individual row tracker. Even if there is a failure, only that tracker row stops, and you would be losing generation from only that row. You won't be losing generation from other rows. They'll be performing as is.
Power loss is negligible. We use consume power, right, for motorizing.
So, yeah, that's why I mentioned self-powered tracker, meaning like it will have its own module with the integrated UPS. It doesn't require any auxiliary cabling. So it's basically, first of all, it's not requiring auxiliary cable. It's not even parasite consumption. It has its own solar panel, small one, depending on the region, like cold or hot, 30 watt or 70 watt to use. And that powers the battery and the motor, if it and the motor. So there is absolutely no power consumption.
Why battery is required?
Battery is required, like in case of, let's say, you have a cloudy days, right? There could be, so during that time, you want the tracker to continue performing. There is still some radiation which is coming even in cloudy days. So that's why the battery is there. And also another functioning of battery is like, let's say your module fails or something, or let's say there is no power at all, no zero radiation, and you suddenly see a high wind event. The tracker is required to go to stow mode, which is its most stable position. And for that, you require again the battery to drive the motor. So battery is a must to have, especially in self-power tracker.
Okay, thank you. So what's the warranty duration?
Standard is which in the tracker industry is like 10 years on structurals and 5 years on electrical components and electronics. And usually they offer extendable warranty.
Okay. On the operations and maintenance side of the tracker, is this something that Next Tracker provides, or is it something that the other standard O&M people, companies can take it on?
It's very standard product, like with any company can take it up. It's not a challenge to maintain Next Tracker product as such. And we integrate, we give remote monitoring through, and we can, you can integrate it to a SCADA system, which enables you to remotely track it.
Understood. The trackers that you have mentioned are like single axis, if I
understand. Yeah, it's horizontal single axis.
Yeah. What would be the value addition of dual axis on the generation increment side, as well as the cost dynamics of it?
So in the beginning, I would say like 2010-11, when I myself started in the solar industry, in trackers especially, they were both going like kind of neck to neck. In my previous organization, we installed azimuth axis tracker, not the dual axis tracker, azimuth axis tracker, given that it has this, you get much higher generation from that. But horizontal single axis tracker, the cost drive down has been significantly high compared to other types of trackers. You take dual axis or azimuth axis. And that's the primary reason why we have more horizontal single axis tracker than other type of tracker. So with module prices falling, only horizontal single axis tracker was able to match it up. You require much larger land as well. So all these dynamics have benefited only horizontal single axis tracker over the trackers.
What would be the lead time and what is a minimum order quantity?
We can take that offline. Sure.
Thanks. Good afternoon. Can you mention about the generation gains of your single axis tracker versus cost?
It's very tough to share that because it's like very site specific. In India, we observed gains of like 16 to 19% for trackers, especially in South India. And of course, there are a lot of white papers being published by other tracker companies. You can see that, like, even with module prices falling to 24, 23, the IRRs are much better than overheating still. Mm-hmm. And yeah, in India, it has monsoons, which the gains are a little bit lesser. Whereas if you see in South America and US, the gains are actually 20% plus. So it is taking a hit, but still the economics are still working in favor of trackers in India.
And regarding the monitoring solution, that remote monitoring solution that you mentioned, do you give it as default or like you have to take?
So the remote monitoring, we give it, we give the Modbus registers to you, so you can monitor all the parameters in SCADA. And NextTracker itself has its own remote monitoring server database where it does its own monitoring in case of any failure.
Does that,
and it keeps tracking.
Is that part of the package or do you have an independent? Do customers buy that online monitoring solution as well, or is it an optional thing to buy?
So we give the parameters like as a standard to Modbus. It's free. You can track how many other parameters you want. But coming to reports from NextTracker is something which we can discuss later. So the parameters from every component are free to be tracked through SCADA system. We give all the Modbus registers, and you can track it through SCADA.
Thank you.
Any further questions?
Hi, this is Radhakrishnan. And what are your major projects in India?
So we have done a project for Adani, and we have done a project for CleanMax. It's still ongoing. We have, of course, a project done for Infosys. So we are doing other projects as well. I mean, almost like close to 300 megawatts. But unless like it's publicly present, I mean, publicly released in press, I cannot tell you.
Any specific in South India?
Yeah, we are doing in Telangana. We are doing in Karnataka. Yeah, lots of projects.
Any other questions?
Any project you have done with tracking with Central?
Not in India. We are done in US. So First Solar is our Asian customer, and we are listed in the Flipkart
Any project you are doing in India?
You mean
in India you are doing any project with Enfil?
With Enfil, right now, no.
Okay.
But we could see in the future, right? So somehow thin film and fixed film kind of gel in India very well. I don't know why. But yeah, even with thin film, we work very well. And this was observed in US and other regions. So it should make sense in India.
Any questions for both of Bharat? I think that would be all. Thank you, Bharat.
Thank you.
Nice presentation.